Hello viewers of Neurootology channel. Today I'm excited to start a new series dedicated to one of the most common yet often underestimated causes of vertigo and dizziness, vestibular migraine. Based on my experience and consultations with many patients, I've noticed it's frequently overlooked, even though it's the third leading cause of vertigo worldwide, after functional dizziness and benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. My goal with this series is to shed light on this common condition and provide you with valuable knowledge to better recognize and understand it. I've noticed that there is a still lack of clear, reliable information about vestibular migraine, both for patients and even among some healthcare providers, which can make understanding this complex condition challenging. This series aims to clarify and explain vestibular migraine, helping patients grasp its significance and how it can impact many aspects of daily life. While this video is educational, please remember that it does not replace professional medical advice. Always consult your doctor if you experience any symptoms to receive proper evaluation and care. Why is vestibular migraine so rarely recognized? Despite being quite common, because it's classified as a non-visible disease, meaning there are no specific lab, MRI or CT scans that can definitively confirm its presence, making diagnosis often challenging and requiring a careful, time-consuming medical history. No single medical test can definitively diagnose vestibular migraine. The first crucial step is taking a detailed and comprehensive medical history to identify characteristic signs, symptoms, and features, but this process requires time, which can be challenging during short visits or busy practice. That's why these patients are often wrongly considered psychiatric cases and referred to psychiatrists too readily. While anxiety and depression can be linked to vestibular migraine, it is definitely not a psychiatric disorder. It's a purely organic condition. Before we move on to a detailed discussion about vestibular migraine, let's first focus on the official diagnostic criteria established by the Barani Society in 2012, which have since provided a standardized framework for diagnosing this condition. The first criterion is having at least 5 episodes of vestibular symptoms of moderate to severe intensity lasting between 5 minutes to 72 hours. The second criterion involves a current or past history of migraine with or without aura, as defined by the International Classification of Headache Disorders. The third criterion requires that during at least 50% of vestibular episodes, the patient must have one or more migraine features with at least 50% of episodes, like headache with at least 2 of these characteristics, one-sided location, pulsating quality, moderate or severe pain, or aggravation by routine physical activity. Or they must experience either photophobia or phonophobia or visual aura. The final 4th criterion states that the symptoms cannot be better explained by another vestibular disorder or by any other diagnosis outlined in the International Classification of Headache Disorders. In addition to the official criteria for vestibular migraine, we should also mention the criteria for probable vestibular migraine, which differs slightly due to the absence of one key point. Specifically, in probable vestibular migraine, either the second or third criterion, such as the history of a migraine or one of the migraine features with at least 50% of episodes, is preserved, meaning either the migraine history or migraine features are present. This concludes our introductory overview of vestibular migraine, serving as a prelude to a more detailed description in upcoming episodes. Thank you for watching, and I invite you to join me again soon for the next series on this fascinating topic. Stay tuned and see you next time.